This isn't going to settle anything today, but it could go a long way towards doing that. The allegation is that Chelsea haven't had a serious test yet. There was the 1-1 against Manchester United, but if you believe that, they've got one on now, for sure. And have Liverpool, at last, got a serious title challenge in them? Our first live game this Super Sunday comes from Stamford Bridge. It's Chelsea against Liverpool, the only two teams in the league still unbeaten. Then it's West Ham, who have lost their last two. Arsenal are the visitors, determined to convince us that they too are part of this title race. Don't you forget about me. At Upton Park, it's West Ham against Arsenal. It's all happening, isn't it? Harry Redknapp in charge of Tottenham. In fact, he's just a mile or so down the road from here in the East End at their hotel, preparing to take charge of Spurs for the first time today against Bolton. So it was with some cunning and careful planning that we asked Glenn Hoddle to join us this afternoon alongside Ruud Gullit and Andy Gray. What do you think, Glenn? Harry Redknapp at your club?
Well, it's a big surprise, you know, what can happen in 24 hours. But personally, I think Harry will do a good job. I think the board know he's English. They've gone back towards the British way, if you like, rather than looking at the foreign way of doing things. And Harry's recent record has been really good. You know, he left Pompey to go to Southampton. That didn't work out so well. He's gone back to Pompey, done a fantastic job there. You just get the feeling that, that was always going to happen. I think Ramos was always on a sticky wicket once you look at the table and you see 2 points. And what the board had done at Tottenham over the history of the last 4 or 5 years, he was always going to go, I felt. And they've made a decision sooner rather than later. And I think, in many ways, I think the fans might be quite pleased with the move.
We're sorry to see Gus Poyet go because, of course, yeah, he is a friend of ours here at Sky Sports. But interestingly, Ruud, Connolly goes as well. So that is the end of this job, the football director, the technical director, whatever you wish to call it. In this country, is that the right thing to do?
I think I still believe in, in the way also that Manchester United does it. You know, just one boss who decides everything. Same also with Arsene Wenger. I think if you have a technical director and a coach and everything, I think the technical director is also a guy who knows something about football. Maybe he has been an ex-player, and he is also having his own ideas about football. On the moment that he's talking with the owner, does he say the same thing that the manager wants? You don't know. If that happens, you have a problem. And that happened already in Holland a couple of times, in other countries also. So I will stick to, you know, to one boss, and I hope that Harry will get that all together. And then I think he will do well. I think he deserves it also. I think he has been to a 1 year time, a terrible spell when he could become the head coach of the national team. Mm. I think he deserves it, and I'm happy for him also because he's a nice guy. He did a great job, so give him the time.
We, of course, have to think about how this affects Pompey as well. I think down there, Andy, Tony Adams has said, I'm not taking over as caretaker. If you want me in, then give me the job. But from Tottenham's point of view, have they now got it right?
Time will tell. We don't know. They thought they had it right with Ramos. They sort of, they weren't secret about the way they went after him and were determined to get him, and it proved not to be the right idea or the right way to go about it. I'm pleased for Tottenham's sake that they have gone back to one man, one job, if you like. I think in this country, managers want to be judged by their own decisions. They want to be success or a failure by the decisions they make in getting players out, who they buy, who they sell, and how they set up the team. I think if you give a manager that chance, that opportunity, then fine. If they fail, they fail on their own merits. And if they make a success of it, it's because of the decisions they've made. So I think it will benefit Tottenham that they have got rid of this technical director, director of football, whatever you want to call him. And I think going back to the way we're used to seeing it managed and run in this country can only benefit them.
Just thinking as you talk, I mean, Glenn, you did work under that system. Had you had the final say on everything coming in and going out, do you think you'd have had more success there if you'd got exactly what you wanted when you wanted it?
I think what happened there is that it was the final say as manager. That was one of the things that you have. But some of the situations that politically, you know, there was whispers going. I think the director of football can work if the manager and the director of football absolutely trust each other 100%. It's ironic, Harry, if you like, he started as football director at Portsmouth, don't forget. And it's, look where it's ended up. He's ended up as Tottenham manager. But at the end of the day, I think that trust has to be 100%. If it's there, if that director of football is being put there just because the board need to trust somebody with the buyers, is he any good? Shall we go and get him, you know, behind the manager's back, which I felt was going on a little bit when I was at Tottenham, then that is a problem. That is a real problem. Genuine problem that you're never going to overcome. But I think football directors can work only if their 100% trust is with the manager. And they also almost go like an assistant and the manager when you go in together.
That's pretty much what it is.
Isn't it not better than the manager appointed the technical director?
Mm. That's exactly what you need to have.
But they don't do that. The board of directors, they're a bit unsure.
They want to have control.
They want their own man in there to hear what's going on. Is he any good? Is this guy their manager's going after?
But, you know, that's
not right.
It isn't right because they should trust the manager. They appoint a manager. They should say, Parry Redknapp, we trust you. Every decision, when we talk to you about players, we trust you. Because that's why we're paying you vast amounts of money and why we've got you from Portsmouth to manage this club. So we have to trust you. We don't need a man in the middle, surely, to say, well, we can trust him, but we're not too sure about the manager. It's almost as if they're saying in the situation that Glenn talked about that we're not quite sure about the manager, whether to believe him or not, so we'll get this other guy in and he'll be the go-between between the two.
I think Alan Sugar actually brought David Pleat in for that very job. Don't forget, David Pleat, when I was there, was already brought in from Alan Sugar, and I think it was there that Alan really said, well, I'm spending a lot of money here. In the end, I want someone to report to me about what's going on the football side. And that's how it was running.
All change at Spurs, though, and we do wish Harry Redknapp, of course, all the luck in the world. Busy day on the football front. Look at this little lot. Chelsea play Liverpool. It's live here from 1:30. Manchester City, who have lost 3 of their last 4, meet Stoke. Spurs play Bolton. It's Wigan against Aston Villa. West Ham play Arsenal. That's our second live game of the afternoon. And Pompey play at 5:00 against Fulham. Football First tonight, 10:00. Straight to match choice, Sky Sports 3 is the place to find that tonight. Spurs, bottom with just 2 points. Only Southampton back in 98 have got out of that sort of trouble and survived. Newcastle haven't won in 7 now, they sit 19th. Stoke we saw drop in 2, the drop zone last weekend. Fulham just outside, there'll be a lot of changes today of course. Bolton falling at the moment, Wigan down. Everton with their point yesterday into 14th. The bag is falling on the back of that defeat by Hull. Borough into 12th. Manchester City down at the moment. Top half looks like that. Blackburn falling, but they got themselves a very valuable point with their late equaliser. Sunderland into 9th now. West Ham sit 8th. Then come Pompey, Villa, Manchester United, Arsenal. Hull, 18 points from the last 20. It's the best start to a debut team in the top league for 115 years. And let's be specific about this. They are not joint top. If the league stopped now, Chelsea would be champions. They have joined Liverpool and Chelsea, the only 2 unbeaten teams, on 20 points. 15 from safety, Hull. Chelsea looked like that. Ashley Cole, left fullback instead of Wayne Bridge. That's the only change today for the team that played in the Champions League in midweek. 2 changes for Liverpool. Aurelio is back at left fullback. Dirk Kuyt, who had started 12 of 13 until midweek, he turns on the right side of their midfield. And up top, Robbie Keane, fit, starts, and we'll hear from him shortly. Right now, the Chelsea manager, Big Phil, with Jeff Shreves.
Felipe, what is the importance of today's game? 3 points, and we are both in the same position, and we play at home, and this is important for us because in the second leg we play in Liverpool. We need to win. We need 3 points a distance for Liverpool. It's very important for us today.
3 points at stake, but psychologically, what sort of advantage could it give the winning side?
Look, who win today have 3 points more and have more confidence for the games, future games, you know. But we have a long way, us and Liverpool, to arrive in the last games and the opportunity for the title. But I think in my head it's more important 3 points than the psychology.
Thank you, Felipe.
Thank you.
It's a fair question, isn't it? What is the significance, the importance of this fixture at the Bridge today?
It's a statement. You know, if you win this game, you make sure that you are a title candidate. And I think that now Chelsea have to be careful only about the last 5 minutes because Liverpool scored in those moments. So therefore, it's a dangerous opponent. They're very tough to beat. They know that also in the last couple of years in the Champions League. So it's, I think, a psychological point for Chelsea to win this game.
It does the allegation that they haven't faced a serious test yet stand up, Chelsea?
A little bit. Obviously, they had Manchester United there. But that really intrigues me today, Richard, whether they push their fullbacks as far forward as they have been. Every game you see Chelsea's fullbacks now, that's the major difference between Mourinho.
Yeah.
The fullbacks are really in the opponent's half when they're in possession. Now, if you do that against the top teams and they hit you on the counter, it'd be interesting to see if Stevie Gerrard just plays behind Keane, whether sometimes, just every now and again, Steve just goes and joins Keane up there and they go 2v2 and they can be hit on the counter. Let's see how they play today. It'd be intriguing to see if they're gung-ho against the good
and
side.
Do you think the trip abroad in midweek affects Liverpool, Andy, or are travel problems these days so insignificant for the big boys?
Well, it's Spain. It was Madrid. It's what, hour and 50 minutes flight?
Straight back.
2 hours
night.
Straight back. First half was a doddle for them. They hardly broke sweat first half. They were so dominant against Atletico. They had to work a little bit harder second half, but I don't think that's a factor. I mean, the big question about it, the importance of the game, quite simply for me, is if we look over the last few seasons about how well Liverpool have done against their main rivals, they've been awful. They've been poor. That's the importance of the game today. They need to show, as they did well playing Manchester United when they beat them, that they can mix it with the big boys and that they can make the record a better one, Richard, because it has been very poor.
This
they'll be
Grand
bottom
Slam
of this league
Andy,
all the time.
Since Rafa Benitez took charge.
Well, there you go.
Look, by some distance bottom.
Well, when you look at Chelsea, they're 25 points behind Chelsea and Manchester United in that league, a mini league. That tells you everything you need to know about how how they need to improve that. And that's what makes this a very important game for Liverpool, probably more so than Chelsea.
You've seen a little bit of difference there, though, Liverpool, don't you, Phil? There is more belief there this year.
There is more belief. Really, and you know, the fascinating thing, and I'm so upset he's not fit, Torres. Mm. I would love to have seen what Rafael Benitez would have done today, Richard, because we simply think he's a little cautious as a coach.
Yeah.
And it would have been interesting to see if he'd have gone with Keenan Torres and Gerrard with a one of a midfield four. But we're not going to see that, sadly.
We're at Upton Park, where West Ham play Arsenal. That's the second of our two live games today. First up, it's Stamford Bridge, where Chelsea are playing Liverpool this afternoon. When we come back, it's Back to the Future with Robbie Keane.
Growing up as a kid, at the Liverpool posters and the duvet, me and my brother in the bunk bed, so it's brings back a lot of memories.
Stamford Bridge first up. Later tonight, Villarreal play Atletico Madrid, who have lost their last three now. 6 o'clock, Sky Sports 3. It's followed by Real Madrid, who are fifth, at some distance now behind Barcelona, who won last night. They play Athletic Bilbao from 8. It is Upton Park for us later, West Ham and Arsenal. First of all, Stamford Bridge with Liverpool and Chelsea. Robbie Keane wearing the colours these days of the club that he always wanted to play for. Time was when he'd wander the streets of Dublin, kicking stones around and dreaming of playing for Liverpool. We took him out this week and reminded him of those days.
Growing up as a kid, at the Liverpool posters and the duvet, me and my brother in the bunk bed, so it's brings back a lot of memories.
Would you say you were a fan or a fanatic?
I'd say probably fanatic, to be honest with you. I mean, I said we had posters all over the wall, and it's one of those when you're growing up, it's sort of bred into you. With your family, and my older brother was a massive Liverpool fan, so I got it from him. So,
what sort of era are we talking about? Who were the players? And
for me, it was John Barnes and Ian Rush was my heroes. John Barnes, obviously, for his silky skills. Ian Rush for his goals that he scored. He was obviously absolutely fantastic goal scorer. But John Barnes, I love John Barnes because the stuff he could do on the ball was incredible, and there are two people that I certainly looked up to.
Is it true that age 15 you had the chance to join your boyhood club, Liverpool, and you rejected it to go to Wolves?
Yeah, I was at a few clubs, Wolves, Nottingham Forest asked me, and Liverpool asked me. So I remember my mother said to me, don't just join Liverpool just because you follow them. Make sure you go to the team that you think is right for you. And at that time, Wolves, was right for me, and I think it's proved to be the case. And everywhere I've been to as a lad, the clubs I've been at, like a journey to be where I am now. And that's at Liverpool, the team I've always wanted to be at.
Now you've got your goals for the club. How much are you enjoying yourself here?
Yeah, I'm loving it. I mean, I'm enjoying playing for a massive club, and playing for a club that's always winning and always wanting to chase for the titles and chase for trophies, and you know, I want to be a part of it.
You've been labelled the comeback kings for obvious reasons. Why do you think this pattern has emerged?
At the moment it's good to be like that, but you'd much prefer to be in a more comfortable position. I think that shows a lot of character, and how desperate the lads are to win games and desperate to do something this year.
If I told you, I mean, you're aware of Chelsea's outstanding home record in the league, not lost for 4 years. The last time they lost was against Arsenal.
Yeah.
That Chelsea actually went ahead first, would that encourage you?
it would encourage us, yeah, because we know that we're quite capable of coming back, but we know with Chelsea's record that they have at Stamford Bridge is incredible, you know. But I always say this, you know, records are there to be broken, you know, and, you know, eventually, you know, someone's going to do. So why not us on Sunday?
Good sport, Robbie, and the contents of that bedroom we sent to the Alder Hey Children's Hospital in Liverpool. Now, talking of that game at the Bridge, does anybody remember that?
Yeah,
4 years, 8 months, 86 games, Andy. Chelsea defended this record.
I think we did the game live, Richard, because they went ahead. We thought, all things. Idigo Johnson in the first, 30 seconds of the match, put Chelsea ahead, and everyone was thinking, oh, here we go again. Another victory for Chelsea. But this was a pretty good Arsenal side. You look at Bergkamp there, laying in Patrick Vieira. Fantastic goal, equaliser. And then they made a bit of a mess of the winning goal, didn't they, the Chelsea defensively?
But since then, a run of that magnitude, the questions they've been asked, it's an extraordinary record, isn't it?
It is. I can remember also with the funny thing is that with Milan we had the same record also. And I remember we were already champion, we won the title and we still had the game to play. And Capello went berserk. He says, I don't want to lose this game either.
How did you end? How did it fall?
We won it also, but it's the character also of and the spirit also of the team and the club. You want to set records. You want to be proud of what you do. And you have to work hard for it. So I think that Chelsea, also now knowing that they have been unbeatable so much, so long time at home, they want to continue doing it.
Use the word fortress, don't you? A lot of people use the word your home has to become a fortress. Well, the Bridge is a fortress at the moment, without a doubt.
You know, when people say they haven't been tested, you have to remember that the champions of this country went there recently, went one up, and didn't win the game. So, I mean, that's tested.
Well, if Liverpool do win today, it'll be their best ever start to a Premier League season. That's another of the prizes they're chasing today. Chelsea have won 7 of the last 11, 10 of the last 12 at Stamford Bridge. Remember Bruno Giroud, 2004 in January? It was his goal won that one. At White Hart Lane today, Harry Redknapp takes charge of Tottenham for the first time, and there he is. If you're the manager, you might as well be in charge. I think that's his view today. We'll keep an eye on what happens, of course, at the Lane and elsewhere. It's a busy day in the Premier League. It's West Ham and Arsenal later at Stamford Bridge. Chelsea against Liverpool. Commentators Alan Smith and Martin Tyler.
Thank you, Richard. And no injury problems from midweek for Chelsea, who go with Petacek in goal. Ashley Cole is rather hurried back into the team because Wayne Bridge has had a difficult couple of days with a family illness. It's Deco's first Premier League start for 6 weeks. Florent Malouda keeps his place despite being substituted at half-time on Wednesday. And up front, Nicolas Anelka, who had 6 months as a Liverpool player 6 years ago. And he's backed up on the bench by two young strikers in Scott Sinclair and Franco Di Santo.
Well, I don't think Scolari would have needed too long to decide on this team. Although Roma made things difficult in the week, the setup is working like clockwork at the moment. Loads of movement, loads of pace, and most importantly, a good deal of confidence. One possible drawback, perhaps, with Anelka in the side instead of D.A. Drogba, they do have to pass it a bit more. Anelka will make his runs, but he doesn't give the side a get-out ball by dominating the air in the air and generally unsettling the two centre-halves like Drogba. If Liverpool do stay compact and get lots of bodies behind the ball, that might just cause a problem for Chelsea.
As usual, Pepe Reina in goal for Liverpool. At the back, Arbeloa is just one booking away from an early season suspension. Fabio Aurelio comes in at left back for Dossena. It does look as if it's the same system as in Madrid on Wednesday when Dirk Kuyt was given a rest, but he's back today in place of Ben Ayoun. And Robbie Keane, a Carling Cup winner against Chelsea for Spurs last season. And there's a place on the bench today for Sami Hyypiä, who's not on Liverpool's Champions League roster this season.
Well, a bit like Chelsea, this team almost picks itself. No surprise that away from home, Rafa Benitez goes for two holding midfielders in Mascherano and Alonso, just like he did in the week. And without Torres, Gerrard will do the job that he's done so often for Liverpool, supporting the lone man up front. He'll have to pick his moments, though, knowing the extra man that Chelsea always use in the middle of the park. Liverpool will not want to get outnumbered in that area. Interesting duel on the left as well. Can Albert Riera, who started really well for Liverpool, pin back Jose Pissingua to stop the right-back bombing up that flank all afternoon?
Well, in terms of Premier League points, it's 2020. The vision of the future for Liverpool and Chelsea may be even clearer in a couple of hours' time. It's all happening in the capital today. Arguably the biggest story of the season up at Spurs, and surely the clash of the campaign so far here at Stamford Bridge. How significant will the Scolari factor be today? Because in the Premier League meetings between Jose Mourinho and Avram Grant and Rafa Benitez, the matches here have been very tight and very tactical. But under Scolari, Chelsea have certainly opened up a notch or two, as they're record shows. But for both these clubs, a fantastic start to the season. 26 games between them without defeat, 50 goals scored, and John Terry fresh from his first goal on home soil for 26 months. How fresh are Liverpool, I wonder? A pretty quick turnaround from the capital of Spain to the capital of England. Have Liverpool come like Roma on Wednesday to wage a war of attrition? Or will they be like Manchester United last month, who really took the fight here to Chelsea? Well, the rain that certainly blighted the Premier League matches in the north of England yesterday has come down to the London area, and it might just add a little bit of a zip to the pitch and another dimension that the first and second clubs have to deal with. First and second, but with the Tigers on their tail from Hull City. And by one of those freaks of the fixtures that seem to come up so often, of course, Chelsea's next game on Wednesday is away to Hull. Steven Gerrard, who, of course, if things had turned out a little bit differently a couple of years back, might have been in blue here today. So here they come, the Premier League pace setters. Scorching starts for both Chelsea and Liverpool. And now their two worlds collide. Chelsea against Liverpool from Stamford Bridge, and it's live.
Two live games from the Premier League this afternoon. It's West Ham and Arsenal later. Last word at 6:30, incidentally. We start at Stamford Bridge. If you're a Sky Digital viewer and wish to go interactive, push the red button on the remote control, and that's where you'll find that menu page. Chelsea against Liverpool, commentators Alan Smith and Martin Tyler.
Well, they have to live with comparisons when they play together for England. They will certainly be compared as rivals today, as will the two teams. A greater optimism than for some time on Merseyside that a title challenge can be sustained, and plenty of optimism here at Stamford Bridge from what they've seen so far from Scolari's side. And of course, Chelsea have stood firm in their fortress on the Fulham Road for 4 years and 8 months, 86 games. That record, Liverpool will be straining every sinew to put to the test over the next couple of hours. The league leaders on goal difference. Set the ball rolling against the second place club. And Alan Smith, is the weather going to be a helpful factor for the spectacle today?
Quite possibly. It's the kind of weather all players actually relish, particularly forwards, because there might just be a few mistakes about on the slippery surface from defenders. But it's going to be interesting to see the way Liverpool do approach this task, because in years gone by, they might just have sat there and seen how the game developed, been a little bit cautious. Now, they can't be too gung-ho with just Robbie Keane up front. Just wonder whether there's a different attitude from them today.
Steven Gerrard supporting. And those who, maybe from Liverpool's perspective, are bemoaning the lack of Fernando Torres, who didn't quite make it despite intensive treatment over the past week or so. It should be pointed out that Liverpool have beaten Manchester United this season without Torres, and with Gerrard only a substitute that day. The same Manchester United who got a draw here at Stamford Bridge. They got a draw yesterday, which has been noted well by these two, the top two at the moment, but bracketed as challengers for the champions of the last two seasons.
Well, they must have taken an awful lot, Liverpool, from that win over Manchester United. But this, of course, is another a building block, isn't it, in terms of their belief. Can they really hang around in this title chase? They might know a bit more about that answer at the end of this match.
Kasingwa, challenged by Aurelio. Gerrard taking it on, top tempo as he loves to play his game at. Felipe Scolari said in his press conference on Friday that he was full of admiration for Liverpool this season. He thought that they were kindred spirits to Chelsea. But he did add that he thought they had no players with magical powers. Stephen Gerrard supporters might take issue with that. Mongers is out there as well, who are capable of wizardry.
He's actually playing quite high up the park, Gerrard. Not dropped in any way.
So is Ashley Cole.
Yeah.
It's a feature of Scolari's strategy. Mikel has had an outstanding season so far, with Makaleli gone and Essien injured. Getting a lot of plaudits from the Chelsea supporters as their most improved player of the season. One or two other candidates, I must say.
Yeah, he does get so many touches of the ball as well, just sat there when the full-backs bomb on. Makes sure he acts as a third centre-half in many ways, vital to the team's shape.
Touched on by Riera, who's contributed wide down the left-hand side. Also crops up in the middle. Helped in the fight back against Wigan. It is slippery, and Xavi Alonso losing his footing. It may be a crucial moment because Anelka can go on. It breaks here for Deco. And it struck Alonso in the end.
Now they had options there, didn't they, Chelsea? They got a little bit caught on the slippy surface, Alonso. Plenty of blue shirts trying to get up there and support. Had his head down, Anelka. A little deflection the other way might have caused problems for Pepe Reina.
It was a quick corner from Chelsea, trying to catch Liverpool out. As they won the game against Roma, inside the last 15 minutes from a corner not taken like that one. The flag's up for offside here, even though the ball ends up in the net from Kalou. Darren Kahn says offside. Rafa Benitez has yet to see his team score, let alone win, in four Premier League visits to Stamford Bridge. Mikel. Mopping up roll. Carragher. His book is as high in the charts as Liverpool are in the Premier League charts. Obviously a good read. Ashley Cole was injured in the match in which he was notoriously booed at Wembley after a mistake against Kazakhstan. His first football since then. As I said earlier, just rather hurried back into the picture. There's one or two problems away from football for Wayne Bridge. Cavalio's header. Riera's in there. Then Terry. Out. Wants to see this out for a Liverpool throw.
And it might just be that Albert Riera gives them the extra man in the middle of the park at times when they get the ball. Liverpool come right in from that left flank. The winger has.
Gerrard. Cleared by Carvalho. Daniel Agger got a real chance to re-establish himself with Martin Skrtel, a long-term casualty. Sami Herpier now just a backup player. Chelsea remember Agger for a goal he scored against them at Anfield in the Champions League. There have been so many meetings, Alan, 20 in the last four seasons. Extraordinary. They've met each other in Europe regularly, of course. An FA Cup semi-final, the Carling Cup here last season, the Community Shield.
Do you know, I think the stat, though, that Rafa Benitez will be most concerned about is that record against the other big four clubs on the road. Hasn't beaten one of them so far in his tenure at Anfield, and that's got to change, you imagine, if they are going to actually lift that title in May.
Now, 10 defeats, 2 draws, one of which was here in February. 0-0, the last time Chelsea failed to score at home in the Premier League. Here's Malouda. Trying to hunt down an opening goal here. Lampard backed up by Deco. Mikel, Basingua. Deco's gone on into the centre. Kalou waiting on the right. Goes the flag.
Well, you know Liverpool are going to be ultra organised in terms of holding that back line, looking right across it. Kalou, he thinks he's level. I think he was. Maybe just leaning into an offside position if we're going to be pernickety. Very close. Remains one of the hardest judgmental calls in the game. We've seen that in the Champions League with Liverpool themselves. Robbie Keane's goal was probably offside. And in the same game, Liverpool got one themselves chalked off for Benny Yoon, which was onside, but given offside. And certainly a goal for Atletico Madrid from Manish, who used to play for Chelsea. Should have stood. That was an appalling decision.
You just like the assistants to give the benefit of the doubt. The attacker, I know defenders wouldn't agree with that, but they're trying to be a little bit too clever at times, judging millimetres.
Headed by Anelka, Kalou chases. Actually, Alan, you're quite right. I was speaking to Darren Cannon half an hour or so ago, and he said, we are told to do that. That's what we do try to do, to give the benefit of doubt to the attackers.
Quite a stop. Both sides just sizing each other up. Early stages, first 10 minutes.
Played by Cole. Joe Cole still out, Drogba still out. And Ashley Cole is back. Michael Ballack, another who's missing from the Chelsea casualty list. Arbeloa has done well there. That's one thing Liverpool, I'm sure, with the attention to detail that Rafa Benitez is famous for. Trying to keep Ashley Cole where he's got to defend rather than producing the attacking dimension, which has been so effective for Chelsea so far this season. Basinga likewise on the other side. Terry's header didn't get very far, and it's deflected in. Well, the shot was by Javi Alonso, and Liverpool do have a goal for Rafa Benitez in a Premier League visit to Stamford Bridge. It wasn't a very tidy one, but it's Chelsea 0, Liverpool 1.
Well, it's just a hit and hope, really, isn't it? A swing of the left leg, and I think Javi Alonso was expecting an awful amount to come of it. I'm not quite sure who it comes off. Is it Carvalho? Just on the edge of the box there. Peter Cech can do nothing about it.
It's Basinga,
It's Basinga. Just half turns on it. Maybe if it had stayed square, the result might have been different, but what a result that is for Liverpool. 10 minutes gone. Now ahead.
And it's certainly game on for Chelsea, for the leadership of the Premier League, for their 4 years and 8 months run here. Basinga, talking about making the fullbacks defend. Well, he was defending then, but in an unlucky way for Chelsea. Gerrard. Wasn't the hugest of nicks, but it certainly found Cech committed to going to his left-hand side, and Xabi Alonso's his sort of range, really.
Well, it's one of those you always tell defenders not to turn away from the ball, and it was a half turn from Basinga, and if he'd have just stayed square, I think he might have been able to block it. He was almost looking to see where the shot was going to end up rather than trying to deflect it away.
That's really what the contest wanted, either way, an early goal.
Now it's going to be fascinating now, Martin, just to see how Liverpool, more than Chelsea, maybe go on and approach this match. Years gone by, they might have just pulled one or two men back into more defensive positions, tried to hold what they have. Will they go on and try and get a second goal?
Gerard Houllier was the manager the last time Liverpool scored here in the league. It was a winner by Bruno Cheyroux, remember him? It was probably the only thing he is remembered for in his time with Liverpool.
Luis Felipe Scolari has seen his side win by fairly conventional means. That's probably gone out. But Anelka, it's Liverpool who've been the comeback kings this season, but now Chelsea are in a position where they've got to try and turn it around in front of their own fans.
Well, you do need a little bits to look if you're going to win the championship. I know it's early doors, it's October, but Liverpool have just had a huge slice of good fortune there.
Riera. Of course, they took the lead on Wednesday and were very strong in the opening half an hour, but couldn't sustain it against Atletico Madrid. Challenged by Carvalho. Here's Deco. He was a loser to Liverpool in the Champions League with Barcelona, despite the fact he scored in the home leg. Lampard, backed up by Mikel and Deco. Chelsea starting to put a few passes together with greater urgency. Palou, a little too quick for his own feet, really. Gerrard. Control from Keane, shielded away from Terry. Count. Aurelio's up there as well. Mascherano. Aurelio can turn. Working with Keane. And it's deflected off for Carvalho, and there's an air of some concern in there for Chelsea at the back.
Yeah, they are rattled a touch, aren't they? And it's not often you can say that about Chelsea's defence. Just choosing who to put up front there with Gerrard and Keane when they do get the ball, Liverpool. They're not going mad. Alonso and Mascherano sitting tight.
Hello. Howard Webb, the referee, playing an advantage. Lampard was clattered into as he laid the ball off. Palou was able to take the shot.
Well, yeah, I mean, he's had the shot, hasn't he? So the advantage has been played. We saw something in the week where they didn't get the advantage and the referee didn't call it back. It's certainly a foul.
Well, it's very similar to the way Manchester United addressed the challenge of playing away to Chelsea last month. They got their early goal through Park. One of now only four that Chelsea have conceded all season. Three of them at the shed end. Where Liverpool, Manchester United and Spurs, believe it or not, scored.
Why are you so surprised that Spurs scored? She played very well, didn't they? Particularly in the second half. Yeah.
Alonso. Now Mascherano. Couch, who was just left out for the purposes, really, of getting a bit of a rest, although he came on late in the game in Madrid. Had a very good season so far. Riera. Alonso has actually had an interesting season in terms of being involved in players being sent off against Liverpool. He's dealing out the aggression himself this time.
Yeah, I mean, another referee perhaps, you know, might have produced a yellow card here. Now, I think quite rightly Howard Webb hasn't. He's come through, yes, it's a dangerous challenge, but he's got the ball, and it's his first tackle, really, Alonso. So Howard Webb just having a little word.
Anelka and Malouda have tried to make an extra man in there. Gambling that Anelka would win it. Masingwa. Mascherano. Nice footwork by Kaut. Linked with Gerrard. Riera. Got the drop on Basingua here, and Chelsea in trouble again. Riero. And Robbie Keane thought it was deflected, but I don't know, you could have seen at the angle we saw it. It's Riera going to make it 2-0 if he could.
Oh, what a waste. You have a look at Steven Gerrard on the far stick. He's going mad at his winger afterwards for not clipping it across. It's a poor effort from Riera.
Mikel. Deco. Hello. Bright idea.
If anybody's going to pick a pass, it's that man, Deco. Just a little bit too much weight on it. Not a whole lot, though. If you are going to go a goal down, I don't think you'd choose Liverpool as the team to do that. They are so well-drilled, well-disciplined, work incredibly hard. And when they've got something to protect, even harder. Bit of possession, Chelsea. But I'd say that Liverpool back four hasn't been overly concerned so far.
The two clubs fixed up a reserve game yesterday, played at Chelsea's training ground in Surrey, and Chelsea were hoping that would be an omen for today. They won it by 4-0. But it's Liverpool here. In the real event, who made the early breakthrough. There goes left foot. Tailor-made, really, for the diagonal ball to where Count is strong in the air, working on the right of midfield.
Now, I think they'd like to exploit that. I know John Terry's edging across to help out Ashley Cole, so they've got their eye on that one, Chelsea. Make sure Count doesn't start winning balls in the air.
Well, Daniel Agger, with the adventure of youth, maybe, Jamie Carragher, way back beyond the halfway line, was just saying to him, get back. I just want to protect what we have. But taking their foot off the accelerator might not suit to Liverpool here. And certainly that's what, for whatever reason it was, Manchester United did after about half an hour. They lost their sense of impetus. Of course, very hard to keep going strong at Stamford Bridge. Kalou came on and got the equaliser that day. It's Deco here.
Haven't got a great aerial threat, have they, Chelsea, when they do manage to get the ball into the box without Didier Drogba? Not known for his heading ability, Nicolas Anelka. Kalou certainly isn't.
No, it'll be Terry from the set players, and Cavallio, of course, will go up then. Liverpool will have to concern themselves, although they don't mark man for man, do they? They prefer the zonal system of defending. Kalou, Deco, Anelka trying to hold it up against the resolute Carragher. Robbie Keane, of course, came off early in Madrid with a slight groin problem, but he's still being asked to be the one out and out forward and try and locate clearances like that last one.
He's not actually naturally suited to that, is he? He hasn't got the pace. He's more of a schemer, Robbie, who likes to drop into those spaces, but he's got to try and keep that high line today.
He was a bit cynical by Riera. We'll see what Howard Webb will make of it. He's going to make of it a yellow card.
Well, I'm sure his manager, Riera's manager, has spoken a lot in the lead-up to this game about the challenge he's got defensively, Albert Riera, up against Basinga, one of the best full-backs around, for skipping up that flank. He did half of his job, he got a goal side, but it's a poor challenge.
Deco goes short with a free kick. And it's drifted in by Mikel. Cavallo and Terry were close to where it landed. Deco. Here's Basinga. Fired across, it was an awkward angle with the ball rather dying on Salomon Kalou.
Now it was a nice enough ball in from Basinga. Just behind Kalou, a touch. Really awkward one for him to twist his body and try and get it on target. He wasn't known for his heading ability, but that wasn't the easiest of chances.
Keller. Decker. Offside. Keller.
He's beginning to see a bit of the ball. Decker trying to get things moving, finding pockets of space.
Mikel. Lampard continued his forward run. Got four for the cross. Gerrard, it's a lovely take. King's almost in his way. Count. It's Liverpool who I think have been credited with the football cliche of you get nothing for being on top in October. But you do feel that this is it's a barometer match for them.
Yeah, I think almost certainly it is.
Gerrard. Well, it wasn't far away and it needed. Petacek struck with a bit of dip on it.
Just wondering if this might have found the net. I think it would have, wouldn't it? Dipping all the time from Steven Gerrard. It's a beautiful effort and it's a fantastic save.
Route, but Chelsea haven't dealt with it. Keane, quick feet, lively mind. Count. Appeals for handball by Keane, not given. Can't get through. And in setting up for defending the original corner, Ashley Cole finding himself across a long way from his base at left back. He's repositioned now as Mikel strides forward. Here's Decker. Lampard's on the move. Liverpool could break here. Keane. It's taken on by Riera. Count.
They're moving the ball about well, aren't they, when they break Liverpool, and with plenty of confidence. Finding each other, just taking the sting out of the game.
Riera.
Chelsea possession.
Needed Lampard to tidy up on the edge of the area.
Yeah, having a tough time at the moment, Chelsea, when they haven't got the ball. Having to work really hard.
I think the error's a little bit unlucky there. Called even by Howard Webb. As the younger generation won't be looking at Liverpool the same way that some of the older members of the football fraternity do. 18 years without the league title for Liverpool. But in the previous 18 years, they've been champions 11 times.
I remember it well. Felt unbeatable at times, Liverpool, particularly on their own patch.
It would have been 12, but for you, Alan Smith, and Arsenal.
What have you done with me?
Anfield 1989 and all that.
Well, Chelsea had to be patient in the week against Roma. I was here and saw an awful lot of the ball, but Roma just sat there and made it difficult. Liverpool won't be quite as negative, but I just fancy the home side will have to be patient and not get overexcited here today. It's a tendency to push on, do things you wouldn't normally. The crowd getting anxious as the game goes on. Got to put a lid on that.
are watching all this with great interest. Will be Arsenal supporters and knowing that their team are up from 3:30 at Upton Park. It is really all happening in London today. And you can see that with us after the conclusion of this top of the table clash at Stamford Bridge. Malouda, and Baloa, they did quite well to buy Liverpool a bit of time there. It must have been close for Anelka in terms of offside.
Henry
Carragher was asking the question, play went on. To get the throw.
They are so well drilled, Liverpool, that when they think it's offside, the players normally are.
A real gauntlet thrown down to Chelsea here by an early Liverpool goal. Lampard. Chelsea have been, as I was saying earlier, winning their matches in, usually in quite straightforward fashion. For Liverpool, it's been anything but. Coming from behind, they've conceded four in the last two Premier League games.
I think it's a result. They've been a bit more expansive this season, you know, using the width of the pitch with Vieira on that left-hand side, and maybe that's taken away a bit of their resilience, but they can afford now just to sit in there and do the jobs and get that meanness back to the game. See themselves through to half-time, a goal to the good, they'll be well pleased.
Came off Arbeloa. And then Kalou. Out comes Reina. With Ashley Cole, whose presence was causing some consternation to Liverpool.
I think it caused Kalou a problem as well, because he saw him flashing across, and instead of shooting, which was probably the better option, just tried to slip one into Ashley Cole.
Liverpool now won a free kick. Robbie Keane was complaining he was being lent on. And Conor Webb was given the subsequent infringement in Chelsea's favour, and it was an obvious one.
That's quite a clever little foul, really, from Xabi Alonso in the centre circle.
Recognised the fourth official, Alan. He's quite awake, Rob Stiles, but still finding a wry smile.
He even gets stick when he's not refereeing, doesn't he?
Don't they all? So, half an hour gone, and so far so good for Liverpool. Cole. Lampard. And below it, four yellow cards already to his name this season. One more would mean he gets it today, missing a upcoming Premier League game against West Bromwich Albion at Anfield in November. Mikel again. That's a deft ball and just a little too awkward for Salomon Kalou in the end.
Yeah, it was quite a straight one, and when it is like that, it's got to be spot on. Isn't too far off. Now pushing on from that anchorman position to try and get things moving. I think he was maybe just off, as Jamie Carragher thought.
Aurelio. He and Dossena really turn and turn about at left back. Nice football by Liverpool under some pressure as well. Chelsea thought they could nick it then. They gave away the free kick. Howard Webb, incidentally, has been named on the shortlist by FIFA for the World Cup referees for the finals of 2010. Great honour for him and the English game. Mascherano with Liverpool's free kick. Anticipated by Basingua. Easy for goalkeepers to kick the ball when it's played across their bodies, but a decent connection. Terry. For Mikel. Kalou found a little bit of room there. Defending we've seen for Jamie Carragher, game in, game out, so long for Liverpool. Count loses out there. Now it's Flora Malouda. Lampard shot. Corner.
Well, I think Liverpool might just want to, you know, shift up 10 yards. They're defending quite deep at the moment, inviting pressure. The ball keep coming back.
Alan, you saw the goal against Roma, who didn't have anybody on the post. John Terry's near post header, and Liverpool are not putting anyone on the post either. Terry's on the move. And Mayara gets ahead to it.
Well, most managers these days do tend to have one, if not two, don't they, on the post, and it can be so valuable.
Climbed by Carragher, the Chelsea players are committed forward. Carvalho's on the way back. But no evidence on the scoreline yet that Chelsea are on the way back. Anelka. Malouda. Anelka's cross. Running away from Kalou. Good defending by Aurelio. Lovely awareness by Mikel of where the space was. Here he is again. He can do so much. Basingua. It's a testing ball. And Lampard, they want handball, Liverpool. Lampard's arm was down by his side. Back with Basingua again. Chelsea lining up in the middle. This time it was Aga who made a good and safe connection.
I could do with getting closer to Basingua. I've got to say, he's putting two crosses there without any pressure. Picking his spot. Riera's got to do a better job.
Kalou. Well reclaimed by Mascherano. Riera, I see how deep he's been forced back. And Liverpool finding it a bit harder to get out at the moment.
Well, there's a lot of yards in between that back line and Robbie Keane up front.
Ashley Cole. Anelka. In towards Deco, watched vigilantly by Daniel Agger. 10 minutes to go to half-time. Liverpool took the lead in the 10th minute. Terry. Deco. And it's Kalou. Basunga's outside him, though. Liverpool cope. Gerrard. Hold it, and not easy. He wanted a free kick. I think that was a last resort shout. Deco. Well, Liverpool would have been looking at their skipper if that had nestled inside Rayner's right-hand post.
Now, the problem Liverpool have got, they haven't got too many options when they do get it forward to those lads. Not enough men in support, and Deco looks as likely as any to cause Liverpool problems in this first half. Whether it's with his passing or having a pop a goal.
We shouldn't forget that Liverpool have done the travelling this week. And to the extent of coming down here from Merseyside, as well as going to Madrid. That could be something you might factor into the second half. Just starting to look a little bit leggy after a really bright beginning. Which, couldn't just get the goal, but Gerrard coming close to a second. Riera hit the side netting. Heading forward with the fours and fives. It hasn't been the case in the last few minutes. Chelsea still had the ball, but Howard Webb's given them the free kick.
Well, we wonder what Liverpool's reaction would be. They've certainly tried to protect that lead and maybe been a bit more cautious than they started off. And as a result, they're coming under quite a bit of pressure. That's 15-20.
The delivery is from Matt Lampard. Terry trying to get a backheader to it. Well marked by Carragher. Singwell has lost out to Gerrard's challenge, but the referee says a foul, and Liverpool are furious.
Oh, what a position that was. Keitel, Robbie Keane over on the other side.
It's a booking for Gerrard as well.
Well, it doesn't matter these days if you get the ball. I think if you lunge in with studs half showing, you're going to get a foul against you and possibly...
Yeah, but that's with one leg. Sometimes when you see the second leg going in...
Yeah. But I think referees nowadays are instructed not to allow that lunging challenge. And it's a shame because it's a fair tackle. And I think Basuengwa...
You heard Phil Neville yesterday, Alan, say the same. If you take the tackling out of the game, he was penalised for one against Manchester United.
I don't think the player tackled always helps the referee because they tend to make a meal of it.
Well, I think that's a little bit of a let-off for Chelsea because the break was certainly on. And here's Lampard. Mascherano stood really firm in the wall. Mascherano was felled in the wall. Keane was back there.
In fact, Lampard convinced it was a corner.
That's surely Robbie Keane. Yeah. Coming up is a great bit of acting from the Liverpool number seven. He just spins away as if it was clearly off the Chelsea player, and the decision went to Liverpool's way. Anelka. 5 minutes away from half time. Terry. Good work by Mascherano. That's a really vital role alongside Alonso. And protect the Liverpool back four, having a bit more to do in the closing minutes of this first half. Chelsea trying to force Liverpool back again. Kalou, Deco, Malouda, Terry with a nice turn. Corner.
Well, I'll tell you what, although they're a goal ahead, Liverpool, they will not want the pattern of this match to continue for another 45 minutes after the break, because it's all Chelsea pushing, and chances are they are going to get the reward if it carries on in this vein.
Danger is averted by their own shortcomings. Chelsea giving away the free kick. Felipe Scolari, 13th game in charge of Chelsea. Is it going to be an unlucky one? His own personal unbeaten record under threat.
Busier half-time than he has as a rule as a Chelsea manager. had to make one or two adjustments against Manchester United, and he might feel he has to here again.
Mikel. Nicely past Mascherano, but Liverpool have the extra man in Alonso doing the intercepting through Gerrard to Riera. Gerrard again. Riera and Aurelio. Maybe symptomatic of the last 15 minutes. Wasn't prepared to put the full-on charge in to keep the move going.
Yeah, they were keeping the ball, weren't they, in Chelsea's half in the first 20 minutes. They aren't now, and those defenders just see that ball keep coming back towards them.
Anelka certainly has his strengths, but Didier Drogba in recent years has at times terrorised Liverpool.
I was talking about the option of playing the more direct ball into Drogba, and this is just the kind of occasion where you've got so many bodies in between you and the goal. Difficult threading. Drogba passes through. Yeah, I've got that option with Drogba, not quite so with Anelka.
Put out by Aga. Gerrard trying to wind up for a pass for Kout, and somehow he's found it. When he went wide, it made it more difficult. Kout to Keane. Alonso looking for Riera, well read by Vasengua. Oh, hesitation there. Ashley Cole and Mikel. Chelsea not only so sure-footed at the back. But you could argue one reason they've had such a great defensive record, so few goals against them this season, is that they have played a lot more football in the opposing team's territory. Look nervy. On one or two occasions here, particularly since they've gone behind. Put back by Gerrard. Cavalier. Here's Anelka. Carragher quite prepared to follow his man right up to the halfway line and get really tight. Deco. Lampard, oh, and Agger's given it away. But, Carragher to the rescue again.
When you think about the number of chances they've created, I suppose, Chelsea, and the number of times Pepe Reina has been called into action, it hasn't been enough from Chelsea's point of view, has it?
One the bogey has gone for Benitez. They've got a Premier League goal under his management here at Stamford Bridge. Now can we get the Premier League win? Only one added minute before half-time. Mikel. Tried to take some responsibility with the ball. Again, Liverpool orderly, good numerical strength. But watching not just the ball, but the men as well. It was Javi Alonso's shot. It was Basingua's deflection that gave Liverpool such a tonic in the 10th minute. To score first at Stamford Bridge, and they've stopped Chelsea replying here, although the shape of the game has changed in the last 15 minutes of this first half, with Chelsea getting more into Liverpool territory. But at half-time at Stamford Bridge, it's Chelsea 0, Liverpool 1.
Liverpool in front at half-time for the first time this season. We're at Upton Park waiting to see West Ham play Arsenal. Ruud Gullit, Glenn Hoddle and Andy Gray. Since they last lost at the Bridge, Chelsea have been in front, behind on 13 occasions, 1-6, drawn 7. They need to get in front here. Half-time, they trail. Glenn Hoddle and Andy Gray are with us. Now, this isn't a barnstormer, is it? But would it be fair to say it's a fascinating match?
Fascinating match, yeah. You mean the first match or the second match?
I mean the first match. The first half of this first match.
It's not a fast. I think that Liverpool is doing their job very well. I think that especially Kuyt and Raya are doing their job very well because they stop the wingers, the fullbacks of Chelsea coming through. Because you need to have width, and they can't get through. They're giving crosses from 20 yards from the goal, and it's easy to defend. I think that Chelsea needs to get up a gear a little bit, and I think that Liverpool till now found the goal. I think it was coming out of nothing.
Have they got that gear? Have Liverpool got enough to hang on from this point, Glenn?
I think
can they
enough.
Break this extraordinary record?
I think the first 20 minutes, you know, they were the better side, Liverpool. They had more possession, they had more territorial possession in Chelsea's half, and they've got the break. As Rude says, they didn't create the goal, really. They've had a little bit of luck. Mm. And let's face it, Liverpool have had a bit of luck this year, and that's a good sign for them.
Forced their luck, though, haven't they?
Yeah, they have. They've got a slight deflection, and you wonder whether Petr Cech might have been able to adjust there. Mm. Might have had got his foot on it. But they found themselves one up, and for me, I think they've deserved it because they haven't allowed, as Rude says, they haven't allowed Chelsea to get around the back. Everything that Chelsea's done is in front of them. They've got to start opening them. They push their fullbacks so far forward, Chelsea, they've got to have overlaps on them. Someone's got to make runs in behind them to create the space. And if not, Liverpool are going to have an easier day.
I think the intriguing thing for me is, since the goal, Chelsea got better and the possession became more. And they asked a few more questions. And I think both have played quite well since then, both teams. I think Chelsea have done OK up to a point, and Liverpool have just sat in there when they've needed to, and they've looked just to counter-attack them any time they can. And they've just got to be careful. This was the only real example, about 25 minutes in, drops to Stephen Gee, and what a save this is, by the way.
Yeah, that's a good save.
I mean, Liverpool hang on to this?
I don't think the word hanging on exists at the moment. They're not struggling. They're not hanging on by a thread.
No.
They're quite composed at the moment. I think Chelsea will get better. I think they'll up the tempo of the game second half. They will ask a question or two. But they're just a little bit susceptible, Chelsea, to the break.
Stevie Gerrard's picked up some lovely positions when Chelsea have been attacking. He really has picked up some cute positions, sort of. He's not come too far back to make it a five across midfield. He's just been in between Keane and their back and their four midfield players. And if they get the ball into him and then they can join from there, I think there's a second goal for Liverpool.
Liverpool also turned them round, didn't they? We saw that at the kickoff. Does that matter? Do players get used to playing a certain way?
Yeah, I think so. I think what it is, and he said already before the game, he said the tactics of Liverpool was a little bit cautious. All of a sudden, you know, when they were playing, you know, they were playing, and there was not much pace in the beginning of the game. And all of a sudden, Liverpool, they played well. They found this goal, and after that, they haven't been really threatened. They just sit back, and you think, oh, Chelsea's pushing, but what do they push? They only had some shots from Lampard from great distance, not even on target. But I think that Chelsea needs to step up a gear. It has to be quicker, and you know, and get at the back, and you know, get crosses in, because till now it was too easy for them.
Some concern at the bridge. This unbeaten home record is under threat here from Liverpool, who have got themselves in front. It's against the San Diego Chargers at 4 on Sky Sports 2. And 2 live matches from the Barclays Premier League this afternoon. West Ham play Arsenal later. But what have you got, Phil? Because you're in a bit of trouble here at the bridge. Liverpool leading by a goal to nil. Signs of frustration, eh, Andy?
A little bit. It's understandable. It's unusual for him. He's going in. It was the same against Manchester United, to be fair, though. They went in 1-0 down against United, came storming back in the second half. Got a share of the points that day. He'll be looking for something like the same today, in the second half of this game. He's not a man, I don't think. I don't get the impression he's the kind of man who'll go in there and quietly say to his players, this is what you're doing wrong, chaps. I mean, if that's anything like the emotion he carries, then he'll let them know in certain terms that this isn't good enough, we need to do better.
What has got to be better?
Last third for me. They'll have plenty of possession. Liverpool won't come out and attack Chelsea from a 1-0, then 1-0 up. So they've got to get their last third stuff. For me, they haven't made enough good movement off their wide play, whether it's the fullbacks or the wide men. They've got to have overlaps. They've got to get blindside runs to open Liverpool up. The minute they start doing that, then you've got to make covering men and you make space, Andy. And so at the end of the day, you know, that's what Chelsea have got to do. For me, Liverpool, we've been asking the question, can they play better against the top clubs? Well, at the moment, they're on course, aren't they?
They are indeed. We'll hear from Ruud Gullit come the end. Andy's going away to prepare for his commentary. That's West Ham against Arsenal. We're at the bridge where Liverpool lead. Alan Smith and Martin Tyler.
Thanks, Richard. Well, it was the ninth game of Mourinho's Premier League management career that he had his first defeat. This is the ninth for Scolari, and the scorer of the goal that beat Mourinho is playing for Chelsea today. Nicolas Anelka, then of Manchester City, of course. Well, there are fresh memories for Liverpool of being in front at half-time Wednesday in Madrid. First time they've experienced this feeling in the Premier League this season. But they certainly showed signs of not going the distance in the Vicente Calderon. But what an incentive for them to try and do that here and go 3 points clear of the side that started the day at the top of the Barclays Premier League. Liverpool 1-0 up. And it's Riera, and it's Gerrard. Well, he went for the pass, and Robbie Keane appreciated it, even though he couldn't control it.
I think he might have been surprised by it, you know. That was Steven Gerrard territory, wasn't it? One touch and shot.
No changes by either Scolari or Benitez at half-time. Gerrard pulling away to try and give a problem to Ashley Cole.
Would have been interesting, though, to be a fly on the wall of the Liverpool dressing room as much as the Chelsea one. Exactly what Benitez wanted his players to do. Was he comfortable with the way that first half developed? His side sinking back towards their own goal, soaking up pressure, or does he want them just to push on a little bit and cause a few more problems up the other end, try and get that second goal?
Well, you could understand it 15 minutes from the end of the match, yeah. But 15 minutes from the end of the first half, it was a policy, it seems a risky one. Chelsea were doing their best to drive Liverpool back. Cole. And Lampard. Here's Ricky Carvalho, who's come to the rescue a few times with important goals. And he's got to think about the movement of Keane, and from the left, Riera. Bissouma's got him in his sights. Mikel. Quickly on Lampard. Riera. Mikel left a leg in there.
He knew he was there as well. Albert Riera knew exactly where Mikel was and got his body in the way and shifted it away. He's done well, hasn't he, the winger, in his first few weeks at Liverpool. Settled in really quickly.
I guess that time in the Premier League with Manchester City helped him, a loan spell.
Steven Gerrard fancies the pop here, it's a long way out.
It wasn't really set up perfectly for him, so Mascherano, not so noted. Blast from distance. Arbeloa. Alonso. Here's Agger taking the fight to Chelsea again. Saw Keane, but couldn't find him. And it's come off for Arbeloa. The way Malouda would have liked to have flicked it on. Andy mentioned at half-time about the way Chelsea came back against Manchester United, but they had players like Kalou to bring on then. Back up forwards here, both 19 years young and very inexperienced in the Premier League. Scott Sinclair and Franco Di Santo. There's Sinclair.
Oh, well, they're not a whole lot of options, are they? He brought Belletti on for Malouda on Wednesday when things weren't going quite according to plan. Belletti, obviously, the more experienced on that bench.
Played wide by Lampard. There was a spell in the first half when Bissingo was getting in a succession of crosses.
Oh, that looks soft. That free kick looks soft, I've got to say. He didn't do a whole lot at all there earlier. Bissingo just ran into him and fell over.
Carragher is trying to make sure no danger of them going in too deep. Holding that line out. Want to come off Arbor lower and count. There is Carvalho. Gerrard to try and make some order of an awkward moment for Liverpool. And he pulled everyone back.
There's a lovely ball in from Frank Lampard, I have to say, from that free kick. Those kind of situations represent perhaps Chelsea's best chance of breaking down this Liverpool rear guard. Flighted in just over the line of heads.
Riera. Supported by Alonso. Mascherano. Now Aurelio. He did go forward in the opening 20 minutes of the game. And Liverpool began briskly and got some reward for it. Maybe a very big reward. Here's Gerrard. Blocked emphatically by Terry. Luda was trying to chase it and he felt Arbeloa deliberately impeded his path. Mikel, that Bruno Cheru goal in 2004, gave Liverpool their only Premier League win, or only league win, in their last 19 visits to Stamford Bridge, in a hoodoo of a ground for them. Lampard, there's a man over here, it's Malouda. Carragher was charging back into the area where he thought Malouda was going to put it, and he was right.
Yeah, well, they worked the ball well there, Chelsea, and got into a position that they haven't often in this match. A couple of men free on the left. That final ball lacking.
Malouda. There's been a half-time hook for him today, as there was here against Roma on Wednesday. Call for Cole to leave it, but it seemed to dip in the air and make it difficult for the Chelsea skipper. Just put his studs to the ball, otherwise it would have skipped away to Cout. Decker. Alonso. This is Aurelio. It's as if, Alan, that Benitez has said something on the lines that you've got to keep Chelsea occupied in their half of the pitch if you can. And by doing that here, Arbeloa has got his body across and in doing so got Liverpool the free kick in a decent position.
Yeah, I mean, they are committing one or two extra men forward now when they get the ball, Liverpool, and they get the reward here. Why he's produced the yellow card, I'm not quite sure, Howard Webb. It's an honest enough challenge for Malouda.
First Chelsea booking, Riera and Gerrard of Liverpool, caution in the first half. Aurelio is Brazilian and take free kicks, not really with Roberto Carlos-like power, but he works the ball, puts some purchase on it, some swerve, but Riera's there as well. That's pretty typical of what we've seen from Fabio Aurelio in his time with Liverpool.
Well, it's almost, so I'm going to have a shot here. If I miss fair dues, we're not going to get caught on the break. Got plenty of men back.
The flag's up. Flag's up for offside.
I'm glancing across at the assistant. He's waited a good couple of seconds before that flag did go up. Crowd thinking it was a penalty. By that time, the decision had been made. It's a good decision from the assistant. And a certain pen, but it hadn't been offside.
And a pen for Chelsea and a penalty for Reina, who would have been off at Stamford Bridge for a second time in his career. But, the first infringement is the one that matters, and that was offside against Malouda.
It's another example of how well drilled they are at the back, Liverpool. Very rarely you see a less than straight line across that back four.
Basinga. And some individual inspiration, but running into Liverpool traffic. At times, Rafa Benitez has tried to drop a blanket over the opposition in away games. He's been successful on many occasions, but not always. Ashley Cole. Another booking, apparently.
Right, it's a silly one from Ashley Cole. Nowhere near the ball. It's a little petulant poke of the leg at his opponent. He thought he was fouled there, and that's why he did it, I think. Well, Jamie Carragher pulled him back initially.
Well, this is interesting.
Well, he doesn't mess about, does he? 11 minutes gone on the second half, and he's seen enough already to want to change things. Young Franco Di Santo coming on, along with Belletti.
Well, Di Santo came on for the corner, which John Terry scored from on Wednesday night. He'd be delighted not that it was an individual impact, but it's just a coincidental, I'm sure, but he's ready to come on again with the more experienced Belletti. Kalou. I'll give you 10 minutes at the start of the second half, seems to be the message. If you can't find a way back, and Reina stops him doing it from that. The single cross, and changes will be forthcoming.
Well, that's a good kick from Pepe Reina. Really was to release Robbie Keane.
Against Mikel. Vieira, usually there when an extra man is required. Alonso, Dirk Kuyt, can he see a way to goal? Not quite. Got his goal touch back recently, of course.
Well, they sat off there, almost inviting the shot. Chelsea, go on, see what you can do.
So, Kalou, the substitute hero of the comeback against Manchester United, is substituted here. It's only his sixth appearance for Chelsea. Franco Di Santo, 19 years old, from Argentina. Chelsea paid a lot of money for him.
Well, it's going to be a change in shape. Franco Di Santo up there, pretty close to Anelka. Belletti over on the right-hand side.
Malouda was on borrowed time. And Belletti, now a very versatile campaigner. Can play right back is his preferred position, and he can play in the holding role in midfield. And as he showed at Middlesbrough, he can attack from the centre of midfield, and as he showed against Roma, he can play wide as well. Gerrard. Alonso. Given away by Riera. Mikel. Belletti's cross. Ashley Cole's in there. And in the end, Di Santo tried to guide it back to Lampard. Was there a knock-on Cole as the cross came in?
Oh, looking at Dirk Kuyt. It initially looked to me as if he had a little shove in the back of Ashley Cole. That's certainly what Cole is complaining about. He went down, tumbled to the turf. good cross in from Belletti. Count knows he's struggling there. There was contact. Was it enough? Not quite so sure it was. Just did enough to put off Ashley Cole as he went to the ball, but it didn't seem to be enough to really do to the fullback what it did. Cole had a chance to get his head on that ball.
Robbie Keane, who came off on Wednesday when Liverpool were 1-0 up. It was his goal, of course, in Madrid. Maybe a little niggle to that same groin problem. And Ryan Babel got a goal here in that Champions League semi-final in April, which incidentally was the last time Liverpool lost. Count. And we're hearing from down on the touchline, Robbie Keane's not been feeling very well.
That's a foul.
It's going to be to his early departure.
There's a high boot there. And not a bad position for Liverpool. Belletti, perpetrator. And this is, well, 25. 28 yards out, still a decent chance. All you're looking for is a little nick off somebody to wrong foot Petacek.
Alonso is doing all the deliberate preparation. Gerrard's just standing there.
Yeah. No prizes for guessing who fancies this.
All Alonso, so it's hit the post, and Carvalho coming back onto it managed to avoid putting the ball into his own net.
That was amazing, you know. Petacek's protecting this side of the goal, but look at him take half a yard step to the right hand side. He was convinced that was going over the wall, and he was nowhere near that shot, nowhere near it. It was a rare lapse from the keeper, and they get away with it, Chelsea.
Well, if there was luck on his goal, there was no luck for Liverpool then. It was a brilliant effort from Xabi Alonso. Liverpool have the corner. And Cech is able to react to that. Here's Belletti on the burst. And Mascherano, there's nothing an Argentine player loves more than that, hunting down a Brazilian.
He'll love this job he's got, Mascherano, just spoiling in front of his back four.
It was a one back there by Belletti. He's given offside in making the contact with the ball.
Oh, getting to that time now, you can sense it in the stadium, just under half an hour to go, where things might just heat up a bit, as Chelsea in particular trying
to find it harder to get himself heard at the moment.
Yeah.
You're right, Alan, the volume's gone up. Chelsea's level of attacking play needs to go up a notch or two if they're going to avoid losing this truly outstanding, unique home record in the top level of English football.
Blimey, again there, Liverpool getting the rub of the green. Didn't look much in it there on Steven Gerrard. Certainly been more of a threat going forward in the second half, Liverpool.
Perry's header only drops to Gerrard. Hoisted forward by Carragher. Babel challenging for it. Not easy for Cech to come out with a throw to a player who might be able to keep possession going. Bang upfield to the rookie, Di Santo, and Anelka, who's got a fair amount of weight on his shoulders in these circumstances. Nice work with the ball, but the pass quite angled to Chelsea's needs. Alonso, Gerrard. Nicely worked by Liverpool again. Two to the left. Babel. Alonso and Gerrard for Babel. Well, it was eye-catching, exhilarating football.
It was, wasn't it? Millimetres away. And Babel, actually, is better suited than Robbie Keane to play in that lone front man with his pace. He's taller, he's better in the air. He certainly threatened the two centre-halves with his movement.
Liverpool was quick off the mark then against Agger. Seemed to be favourite to get to it. Gerrard. Proves your point, Alan, really. Unable just to stretch towards that one. And Ashley Cole has got to be very careful.
He doesn't look actually fit. I know he's come back a little earlier and he's getting a yellow card, Mascherano, for descent. We've seen that before, haven't we? Mm. Old Trafford. He gets his body in the way and, well, he's on a yellow card, Ashley Cole. What kind of a challenge is that? John Terry, you know, he's been trying to get close to Cole to protect him, and I'm not sure he is fully match fit. Ashley Cole.
Four players have been sent off against Liverpool in the last five Premier League games. So Ashley Cole is walking a tightrope. It's deep from Gerrard. Very good claim by Cech. If he's going to go out there, he's going to have to get it, and get it he did. 20 minutes gone in the second half. Liverpool still lead.
Yeah, 20 encouraging minutes from Liverpool's point of view. They would have expected a fight back, an onslaught, and it's not quite materialised. If anything, they've been more comfortable.
Aurelio played it against Anelka, who was first to the loose ball. So Jamie Carragher is so good because he's a smaller defender and he's very quick on the turn. Deco. Deco's cross. Franco Di Santo, incidentally, went on Chelsea's pre-season tour to the Far East and scored some goals out there. Scolari has seen at first hand what he can do. But here's Mascherano with a bit between his teeth and the ball at his feet. When it ricocheted, it wasn't much more than that from Gerrard, but it's come to Mascherano, who wasn't thinking about scoring himself, but trying to lay it on the plate for Babel.
No, he's never on, though, that pass. Never on. Could have afforded to have taken a touch. He'd got Dirk Kuyt bombing up in support if he'd have heard a shout.
Di Santo for Lampard. And the two runners coming from different angles at the Liverpool defensive setup since the substitutions. Galletti could be the one that they have to keep a special lookout for. Here he is. Deco. And here's Bisingwa. Nalka going in near post. And Agger was there as well. He might be best advised to take a considered recovery here, but of course, if the physio comes on, he'll have to go off, and even only for a moment, Liverpool will be a centre-back light, and in a moment, a game like this can change.
Yeah, it was top defended, and Alka was not going to get to that ball. Agger and Reina made sure of that.
Goes Aurelio. Mikel. We're into the last quarter of the game. Liverpool have led since the 10th minute. Had if he needs attention, it's all very well trying to use up a few extra seconds by staying on the ground, but
Well, I thought John Terry fouled him now, actually. Lifted his boot up onto his thigh.
I think he agreed with you. Belletti.
Well, it's not happening at the moment for Chelsea, is it, in the second half? Liverpool will be well pleased the way things have progressed and developed.
Just a quick reminder as we head for a crucial last 20 minutes here. West Ham and Arsenal still to come. I'm sure that'll be a terrific match as well. 3:30, Sky Sports 1 and HD 1. Sammy Lee, back at his spiritual home. Been through so much for Liverpool. He'll know that Chelsea took Liverpool's own record for 63 games without defeat at Anfield to set up this 86 mark that's really under challenge with every passing second here.
We've seen it threatened, haven't we, several times in the past, and they've always gone on to get an equaliser. And then perhaps a winner, but at the moment there's no real sign of that happening. I just wonder whether John Terry, last 10, he might go up as a makeshift centre forward. He's done it before under Mourinho.
Count. Deco's passing skills haven't yet led to Chelsea unhinging Liverpool's organisation. Not just organisation, but application as well. Players know all about the history, but we saw Sunderland overcome their personal history battle against Newcastle only yesterday. Records don't last forever. Belletti. Masungra still hovering out there, hoping that he can stretch Liverpool. Lampard, and it's promising in the build-up. Looking at the end of it for a pensive Scolari.
Well, the substitution up until now, if I could, the Santo and Belletti, it's not really made a noticeable difference to the pattern of this game.
Here's Mikel.
I'll have to try something else before the match is out.
Deco. DeSanto scuttling to keep it in, which he does. Couldn't find Deco or Lampard, but here's Cole. Sweeping header by Aga. Vieira tucking in again to give them some solidity. Lampard. Got back on his right foot. Ashley Cole! Lovely set up by DeSanto. Best chance for Chelsea.
Oh, by a long way, what a chance. And Ashley Cole, it almost seems to, well, he slices it, that's for certain. Doesn't get nearly enough on the ball. It all came about via Albert Vieira trying a really dangerous cross-field pass. Presented possession to Chelsea. They haven't had many chances in this match. It's the best. Pretty even, isn't it? It's not bad, is it? Liverpool 2 and one goal.
Well, we counted on the post as on target, didn't we? Alonso, Gerrard tipped over, and the goal, we would count that as three. Riera.
Yeah, I might have just got an earful from his teammates for that little dodgy chip pass he tried in the middle of the park that put Liverpool on the back foot, leading to that Ashley Cole chance.
Bamble just loitering slightly offside, he'll come back on. Try and get into some space. Gerrard. And the real risk to check was that it might have caught him out and gone straight in. It wasn't what Steven Gerrard quite had in mind. 16 minutes and counting. Basingra. Anelka. Lampard in there. DeSanto's starting to cause one or two problems with his skill in the air.
Not the biggest, but not the smallest either, but he times his jump well. And he's got a good vision. A little cushioned header into Ashley Cole's path.
Well, I guess what the chasing pack, which you'd obviously say Manchester United and Arsenal, but you can definitely add Hull City. So what would want is a draw here. Anelka. Paletti. Great ball for Deco. Still Deco. Corner.
Well, he had to get that shot away quickly. Two Liverpool players converging. Once again, DeSanto involved in the air. Once he's gone inside here, Deco, he knows he's only got a fraction of a second before the challenge comes.
Such a gripping contest. Chelsea still behind in it. And Reina rattled.
Well, you've got to expect John Terry to go in and challenge for that ball. Actually, Reina didn't make a move and he's got stuck under his crossbar. It's always a dangerous move for a keeper. Chances are you will get hit as bodies pile in. That's the life and times of a keeper. How much of an elbow there was, we shall see shortly. Right under the crossbar from Lampard. It was a raised arm from Terry, no doubt about that. Carvalho helping out, but not too much to shout about.
Alan, I talked to a lot of other Premier League managers who say that they think in theory you can get at Reina. But what actually happens is they ring-fence him so well, usually, with the Benitez zonal marking. But that type of clash doesn't occur very often. If it does, it's usually, as it is here, a free kick.
And he, got himself into a position where he couldn't really jump for the ball, and that's why he got in trouble.
Babel! Who banged one past Petr Cech in the Champions League last season in very similar circumstances.
Boy, how close was this? He couldn't have hit it better. Oof, a yard wide. Wonderful effort from the Dutchman. I think Cech's got that covered.
Been his style to get his team to play further up the pitch, but they're finding it very hard today, and it's a compliment to Liverpool that that is the case. The Liverpool supporters will be counting the minutes here. Babel. Riera still trying to occupy Chelsea at the back. I think he's an important part of seeing there themselves, if they can, Liverpool, through this to victory. Mikel. Anelka. Deco. And Gerrard, more and more, just a midfield player rather than working off the front. He's trying to push out, though. Well, if Liverpool were to win this, it would knock Harry Redknapp off the back pages tomorrow, I think. Ashley Cole in there again. Reina's coming for it. Goes for the fist. Good fist, too. Deco. Mascherano. Impeded by Deco.
It was a real lapse from Deco.
Red's got the card out again.
He was actually looking up to see where he was going to play it before he'd properly got the ball under control. See there. He's just stretching for the ball, but it's that tug back afterwards that earns him the yellow card.
Right. Level on the bookings, three apiece. Mikel. Chelsea still seeking to level it. And the stat that really matters. Basingua. Oh, they're happy that it comes in at that angle. Well, we showed it to you earlier in our programme. The Arsenal win here, February 2004. Last Premier League home defeat for Chelsea. Claudio Ranieri was their manager then. Riera.
You've got to give Liverpool credit for the way they've approached this second half. They've pushed on a little bit and committed more men forward, so it isn't such a one-sided affair.
It's excellent football from them again. Gerrard. Into Babel. It's a multi-pass move and sensed in the talk since they got back from Madrid from the Liverpool camp that they had a genuine belief that they have improved themselves as Premier League competitors this season and that they were ready for this task.
You can see it in the body language, you can kid yourself about that sometimes, but there does seem an added authority and belief about them through that Liverpool camp. And they can go head-to-head against the likes of Chelsea and come out on top.
And they're thrilled with what they're seeing. The minority in the stadium. And Chelsea, I don't know if they're going to produce the type of response that you can say is that of potential champions. They've got 9 minutes plus added time. Serrano, Belletti will just settle for the throw. Want to do it quickly. That's always the best policy. Carragher across. It's not been much nail biting for the Southwest Londoners here, but there is now. DeSanto making a nuisance of himself. It's Frank Lampard trying with all his might to get some power into the header.
Well, DeSanto has made a difference with his aerial threat. He's caused one or two anxious moments for Liverpool.
Mikel. Terry. Campbell. Still here over the ball rather than going up to add his presence. Trying to work Liverpool around, draw them out a little bit. DeSanto got the touch, but they trust him, his teammates, looking for that type of supply.
Yeah. They're just trying to mix it up, really. They've tried the passing game and it hasn't come off. Once or twice along, the ball doesn't hurt.
So much to celebrate here in recent seasons. The fortress in the Fulham Road, Stamford Bridge. But the invasion party is getting nearer and nearer to breaking it down.
Well, if you beat Manchester United at home and then Chelsea away, I think you've got every right to be pleased and have real belief that you are in with a shout of this Premier League title.
Beaten Chelsea yet. Anelka, Deco, DeSanto against the torso there. In goes Mikel with a foot raise maybe.
Well, he's going in a bit like them as well, Mikel.
Mikel's been sent off in the past by Howard Webb. Carling Cup final. Well, Scott Sinclair Another boy, really, in Premier League terms, being asked to do a man's job here. Not eligible for the Champions League, at least in the group stages. They left him off their roster. But he could come back into the picture today and come onto the pitch in a time of dire need. Certainly quick. Aurelio, Riera. What happened towards the end of the first half when Liverpool really showed signs of sitting back hasn't happened in the second half.
No, I think that's all credit to Liverpool for that. Whether that's something Benitez spoke about at half-time, wouldn't be surprised at all. He wouldn't want to see the pattern continue as it was in that first half.
But here's Cole. Deco. Been played in front of Liverpool though. Mikel trying to change that. Gerrard's come away with the ball. And space for Alonso, at least for a moment. Gerrard again. One of those Hollywood passes of his. Count. Can he find Bubble? And he went to try and drive it across it.
Weren't bothered about supporting Bubble there, Liverpool. They just let Count and him get on with it.
The ball by Belletti. Had a bit of curve on it if Agger hadn't been able to deal with it. But deal with it he did. Deco. Belletti. The one that flew in at the Riverside. When they won so comfortably, he'd taken a lesser scoreline last weekend for one to go into Liverpool net here.
Well, if they don't win this game, Chelsea, in one way, might just do them a favour, take a bit of that euphoria away. Everybody talking about them as possibly going through the season unbeaten. What a win it would be for the visitors.
Asking Benitez whether Liverpool can go through the season unbeaten.
Yeah.
But there's still time. This is a league of late goals, remember. Belletti couldn't disguise his intentions. They don't count. Given the chance to freshen up by only a cameo role on Wednesday. Spent the best part of 88 minutes here. Lucas. Gerrard being told to really get back into midfield. Lucas is going to play on the right, I think. A brief to get back. As Riera the other side, Bubble just the one outlet. Mikel. I said earlier he can do most things in the game. One thing he hasn't done yet in his very promising career is score a Premier League goal.
Yeah, the shooting from long range hasn't been the best today, Chelsea. Whether it's Mikel or some of his teammates, and to that point now where it doesn't look like it's going to happen for them.
Arbeloa. Cole had missed a great chance a few minutes back. Lampard is possessed by Riera. Echo. happy to return the ball. Prayers that haven't been answered for the Chelsea fans, but for Liverpool. Sami Hyypiä, still a valued member of the squad. Come and head a few away, Sami, I think is the instructions. Riera. Good performance, Alan.
Yeah, he's had a good performance. He's had a good season so far. He's looked strong in there. He's played his part in denying Bissouma on that side from having as much effect as he has done this season. But yeah, Sami Hyypiä, get your head on some of these balls that are likely to be coming your way in the next couple of minutes.
Three added minutes. Liverpool have the ball and they have the lead. Had the lead for a long time. 80 minutes. Belletti. That came off Hyypiä's head. No time for niceties. And Liverpool at the back.
Nervous moments.
Oh, John Terry has gone up. He's in the mix here. Hyypiä, conspicuous with that mop of blonde hair. And that was Anelka, and that's just going to trickle wide.
I just needed to try and head that square. But if the record had to finish somewhere, and if you're going to lose, you might as well lose to a team of the quality of Liverpool.
Incidentally, John Terry is just one goal away from equaling the all-time record for a Chelsea defender, Peter Sillett, the right-back in their 1955 championship-winning team. Had the 34, most of them penalties, I think. Terry got his 33rd on Wednesday. And here's Mascherano. Chelsea's urgency to try and get the ball back is understandable, but every free kick they give away in doing it is taking Liverpool a step nearer to three most valuable points. Two facets of it, really. First 20 minutes when they played so well and got the goal. Not a great goal, not a goal maybe worthy of winning such an important game, but it's looking as though it is going to win it. And then the way they played in the second half in defence of that lead. Hyypiä. Picked up here by Di Santo. And why not? There are only seconds left.
Yeah. I mean, they have, depending on their amazing resilience, Liverpool, that inbred discipline that they've got under Benitez for long portions of the game. And the nose is in front and they've really coped with it well, particularly in this second half where they have offered a threat going the other way. They've relieved the pressure off the back four, Liverpool. And very nearly there now.
He's not a man to panic. He's inwardly, I'm sure his heart is racing. So, so close, Rafa Benitez, who suffered so much at Stamford Bridge. And what a statement from Liverpool here. I think the die is cast. It's going to be Felipe Scolari's first defeat in management at Chelsea. Because Liverpool have the ball, they have the time, they have the lead, and they have the win. Chelsea's home record has gone, and it's Liverpool who have cracked it after 4 years and 8 months and 86 games. It's the end of the Stamford Bridge bogey for Rafa Benitez. It's a win which propels Liverpool, his Liverpool, to the top of the table. Xavi Alonso with the goal, the deflected goal in the 10th minute, and Jamie Carragher and company defended that not easily in the first half, but strongly in the second. It's a fantastic way to strengthen the belief that a title challenge is finally coming from Merseyside in the Premier League. It's their best ever start to a Premier League season. Chelsea have to take it on the chin. It's always a Liverpool mantra that you win no silverware in the autumn. But these 3 points must feel like a trophy for them today. Chelsea 0, Liverpool 1.
Well, well, well. You can see what that means to Steven Gerrard and him, no doubt, Jamie Carragher. Right at the heart of it, as usual. As Martin was saying, no trophies yet, but that surely gives us a steer. Liverpool clear at the top from Chelsea. It's a busy day in the Premier League at White Hart Lane. Harry Redknapp has said good afternoon. New man in charge, of course. That appointment came overnight, and a very, very warm welcome for him too. And Harry's magic might already be working. Chelsea beaten by Liverpool, City a goal up against Stoke, Rubinho the scorer there, Spurs lead against Bolton, Pavlyuchenko the scorer, and Villa one up at Wigan, Gareth Barry with the penalty. West Ham Arsenal to come, Pompey play Fulham at 5, football first tonight, 10 o'clock, Sky Sports 3, straight to match choice. Next up for us, West Ham against Arsenal. And later tonight, Villarreal play Atletico Madrid at 6 on Sky Sports 3. It's Real against Athletic Bilbao at 8 in the same place. Not sure you were too convinced at half-time, but did you ultimately enjoy that?
Yeah, it was better. I think that today, I think Benitez, I think tactically he, I think they won the game. I think especially two white players, Kaid and Raira, they were excellent, you know, doing their job. The fullbacks, they had no space to get behind them. So therefore, I thought that Chelsea had no imagination at all. It changed a little bit with the two strikers up front. But I think that Liverpool, they were comfortable, they worked very hard, and I think they deserved this win.
And you said earlier, Glenn, that they've had some fortune this season, Liverpool. You could argue again today in the scoring of the goal, but they keep forcing their luck, don't they? And that's a very nice habit to have.
Oh, it is, it is. And that's something different this year. You know, I think they had belief that they can win games without playing at their very best. But I felt they deserved their victory the way they defended. They looked comfortable in possession. There's the goal, good fortune. But that was still a long way to go, Richard. You know, they had to hang on as such, and they didn't hang on. They actually kept possession. And to be fair, Chelsea found it very, very hard to penetrate.
They nearly made it two here.
Well, there, you see the goalkeeper, Peter Cech there, has gone behind the wall. He's got a, that's his side of the goal. For whatever reason, he feels he's going over the top of the wall. No. And he's been very lucky, very fortunate to get away with
that. He was gambling there.
He was gambling.
Yeah. And nearly paid a heavy price. Jamie Carragher, the boys named as man of the match. Here he is with Jeff Shreves.
Jamie, just what does it mean to be the first team in 4 years to come here and win in the league?
Well, I mean, it should, you know, give our confidence. It puts us, you know, top of the league. But as I said, a long way to go. But, you know, psychologically, that should, you know, give us a big lift, really, because that's, you know, before today, I'd probably say that was Chelsea was probably as good as anyone in Europe. They've been playing the first few games. So to, I think it's maybe, you know, 3 or 4 years now since they've been beat. It's a great record. I mean, obviously, it couldn't go on forever. They had to lose some time, but, you know, just delighted it was us.
And the fact that you've already beaten Manchester United at home this season, surely it bolsters your title-winning credentials even further.
Yeah, it does. I mean, as I said, we're top of the league now, but I mean, there's a long way to go. But as I said, I mean, you know, Chelsea and, you know, Man United have been there over the last 4 or 5 years. Ourselves and Arsenal are, you know, trying to challenge them, what they've achieved over the last, you know, couple of years. And as I said, hopefully we can bridge that gap this season.
But to smash that record is almost like winning a trophy itself.
No, it's, I mean, it's one game. I mean, as I said, it's a great record, but it was always going to go one day, and just glad it was us.
Well, you've definitely got the bubbly of the Barclays man. That's well done, Jamie.
Hey, thank you.
Thank you. You got all that, Rude?
Can you translate that? Maybe subtitle it next time.
We understood that.
We don't need it, in fairness. We don't need it. He's a top boy.
No, yeah.
What does that do for your confidence?
Oh, great. Also, in the way, in the fashion they did it, you know, as a team, they work very hard. Yeah, sometimes, you know, we want to see always teams attacking. If you come to Chelsea knowing that they have been unbeaten so well, and then you get a victory like this out, I think that Chelsea didn't create much. None at all, I think. And that's part of their tactics, and also they're willing to win. And credit to them.
Bookies aren't buying in just yet. They remain third favourite, Liverpool, despite the fact they've gone there to win today. Chelsea 11-10, Manchester United 2-1, but they have come in, Liverpool, at 4-1. Arsenal play next at Upton Park, which is where we are. 9-1, the Gunners at the moment. So it's to East London, where West Ham play Arsenal, who want to remind us they are in the chase.